Before we jump into the story, how about we learn a couple of verses? Please repeat after me. The whale, she eats so well. She opens her mouth, but not to yell. She has a story for us to tell. Get on your boats. We're about to sail. Good job, guys. So let me ask you, what do you think the next story is about? Yes, it's about a whale. You got that right. Today's main character is the southern right whale that inhabits oceans south of the equator. So if you go to any of these places, Argentina, Chile, Brazil, Uruguay, New Zealand, or South Africa, you might be able to see a southern right whale. These whales are very curious and friendly, and these calluses around their bodies make each whale unique. It's like their own hairstyle. Now, let me ask you, what do you think whales are? Are they fish? No, they are cetaceans. That means that they are marine or aquatic mammals, and their closest relatives living on the ground are hippos. Do you see the resemblance? I don't know. Well, my friends, it is time to begin. But please stay until the end, because after today's tale, I will be sharing some fun facts about whales. Why the whale lives in the ocean, based on a Tehuelche story from La Patagonia, Argentina. A lot of things have changed since the dinosaurs walked the earth. For instance, did you know that thousands of years ago the whales lived on land? Yes, you heard me right. They did not yet live in the ocean. Once, there was a whale so big that she needed to constantly eat. Her name was Gus, and she lived in the southern Pacific coast. Every time the whale opened her mouth to yawn or talk, she would vacuum, swallow, gobble down anything you could think of. I mean, we're talking about all kinds of things and beans. Oh yeah, Gus ate them faster than you could say jelly beans. Do you think you could say jelly beans really fast? Here we go. Jelly beans, jelly beans, jelly beans. Good job, guys. For a while, people, things, and beans were disappearing from the scene. Those who had not yet been swallowed by the whale began to wondering what was happening on Earth. If things kept going on like that, soon there would be nothing left, not even a hat. For instance, a house or a palm tree that had been there for years, by the next day, had suddenly disappeared. Or a herd of cattle munching on the grass, or a group of children playing by the shore, they would be gone in seconds, faster than you could spell bones. B-O-N-E-S. Do you think you can spell bones really fast? Let's try it. B-O-N-E-S, B-O-N-E-S, B-O-N-E-S. Good job, guys. Well, those who had not yet ended inside the whale were growing quite pale. Something needed to be done, and so they called their local hero, a boy named Elal. Do you think you can call it with me? Let's call him Elal.
Elal!
Elal! Elal. Etal, amigues, it's me, your local hero, Elal. Here's the thing. Despite his youth, Elal was known for always seeking the truth. Also, he knew of many things, including a couple of magic tricks. After the people shared with Elal their concerns, the boy hero said,
I will investigate.
And off he went to observe. And he searched here, and he searched there. Oh, he searched everywhere, until he found Gus the whale. Elal followed the whale for a whole day and took many notes, because that's what you do when you're conducting an investigation. At last, El Al concluded,
"Gus come mucho. She eats so much. If she keeps eating like this, soon there will be no things and beings. I must do something about this. Debo hacer algo, o todo desaparecerá en un tris, or it all be gone in a blink."
But here's the thing. El Al always thought that a gentle approach is always best, especially when you don't want to cause any stress. So El Al went to Gus and politely asked her,
"Gus?"
"What?"
"Will you please open your mouth? I would like to look around."
"Gus, por favor, abre la boca. Mira que pareces loca."
But Gus tightened her lips and looked away, as if she had nothing to say. El Al did not give up. Clearly something was up. The boy suspected that Gus was hiding all the things and beings that had gotten lost. And so, El Al, the boy hero, turned himself into a... Can I get a drum roll here? This is where the magic happens. Here we go. Good job, guys. And so El Al, the boy hero, turned himself into a...
zero!
Not what you expected? Oh, come on, guys. A zero, I mean, is a good number. Just imagine if you have $1 million. I mean, there's a lot of zeros right there, right? Well, but I'm kidding. He didn't turn himself into a zero. But this is a great opportunity to talk about superheroes. Tell me the ones you remember. Go ahead and say it aloud. Yes, yes. We got Iron Man, Captain America, Spider-Man, Thor, Superman, Hulk, Batman, Wonder Woman, Wolverine, Black Widow, oh, Doctor Strange. And what about Black Panther and Green Lantern? Oh, and Aquaman. What about Supergirl? Shazam. Yes, and there's so many, many more. Now that we have agreed that superheroes come in all shapes and sizes, let's see what kind of superhero El Al turned himself into. Everybody, give me a drum roll. El Al, the superhero, turned himself into a mosquito. You didn't see that one coming, right? And so, El Al the mosquito came flying and buzzing around Gus the whale when she was not aware. And when Gus opened her mouth to yawn, El Al the mosquito flew in, passing her tongue. And he went down her narrow throat until he arrived inside the whale's belly, where he found more than jelly. Guess what he found?
Yeah, the people from all around the town. They were all there.
Thankfully, they had not been digested. When the people inside the whale's belly saw the mosquito, they knew it was their local hero. But soon, they feared that if El Al had been gobbled down, then who was going to help them out? It was then when El Al the mosquito said,
"Fear not, my friends. Aquí estoy. I'm here to save you all. I have a plan. We'll make our fingers dance can-can."
Then he explained what they needed to do. They had to tickle the whale's belly until she would poop. Now I'm kidding. But wouldn't that be fun to watch? Or too gross? Oh yeah, gross. Well, the thing is that El Al hoped that Gus would sneeze or cough them out. Otherwise, they would have to find a different route, if you know what I mean. So El Al said,
"Everyone listen up. At the count of tres, we are tickling this whale's belly, so do your best."
They all raised their hands and stretched their fingers out. It was time to get out. Everyone, it's time to help out too. Ready? At the count of tres, we're going to wiggle our fingers. Wiggle them as if you are inside the whale's belly. Here we go. Uno, dos, tres, wiggle. Yes, keep wiggling, tickling. And after a minute, the people stopped and waited for the whale's reaction. But Gus shook off the itching. Oh, the people needed to get back into action. And so they raised their arms and stretched their fingers out and continued tickling after the countdown. Tres, dos, uno, tickle attack! Tickle, tickle! Yes! And soon, Gus the whale was giggling. And before she could stop herself, she was laughing so hard that some people even heard a fart. You know, that's what happens when you laugh so hard. And when she was laughing like a crazy mad whale, all the things and beans that she had gobbled down a while back were shoot out like a dart. Well, after that, El Alde Mosquito went to check that everyone that was out was safe and sound. Then, El Al firmly but kindly said to the whale,
Gus,
what?
From now on, you must live in the ocean.
No, why? No!
There, you can eat cualquier cosa, anything you want.
Really? Let me think about it. All right.
So in time, Gus and her family and her whale friends learned to swim. And today, they enjoy eating all kinds of fish. And for a long time, this deal worked like a charm until we arrived to current times. And here's where the second part of the story begins. The story of a whale that after eating fish, ended up eating garbage. Not too long ago, Gus the whale was found on the shore, crying in pain.
Oy, 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 oy.
Oh, oy, what a pitiful whale. More than one person thought that Gus had gotten tired of the ocean, but they were wrong. So, who do you think they called? Yes, El Al the boy hero. Can we all call El Al? El Al, El Al. And he came to check on Gus. When he examined her eyes, ears, and tongue, he knew something was wrong. And so El Al turned himself into a mosquito and went inside the whale. Immediately he noticed that her insides did not smell very well. He thought that the whale needed to brush her teeth, but then he remembered that she was a baleen. Do you know what that is? Those are the whales that instead of teeth have whalebone on their top jaw to filter their food. Well, as El Al the mosquito went down her narrow throat, the stinky smell became more powerful. When El Al the mosquito arrived inside the whale's belly, guess what he found? I'm telling you, it was not jelly. Yeah, it was a mountain of trash. Oh, it was pretty bad. It was all the things that people had discarded a while back, from all types of plastics, beach toys, and even ink cartridge. Oh, no wonder why the poor whale had such painful belly ache. Just imagine eating garbage like you eat a cake. The people thought the whale's belly had to be cut out. Quick. Oh, but El Al knew there was another way around.
Do you remember how he solved the problem last time?
Yes, the tickle treatment.
Yet, this time, they called all the people that lived around, men, women, and children, to help out. But before giving the whale the tickle treatment, it was best to calm her down. So they all began giving her a soft belly rub while singing a lullaby, and some even gave her a hug. So my friends, put your hands on your bellies, use your imagination, and repeat after me. Heal, heal. Let this belly heal, heal. Today or tomorrow, you will be healed. Now that the well was more comfortable, the people stretched their arms and fingers out, and at the count of tres, they did their best. Ready, friends? Uno, dos, tres, tico! Yes, and soon Gus the well was giggling. And before she could stop herself, she was laughing so hard that some people even heard a fart. You know, that's what happens when you laugh so hard. Oh, I'm telling you, Gus the well coughed out all that trash. And after that, the people from around those parts promised never to litter outside. Instead, they would keep their trash in bins and cans. Oh, I heard that Gus the well is doing much better today.
Oh, yeah. I'm totally doing much better today. I even changed my diet. Doctor's orders. I am pescatarian these days. I only eat my veggies and tiny fish.
But I also heard some of her cousins around the world are still getting sick from eating trash.
Oh yeah, my cousin Frank, a blue whale, ate a submarine the other day and it hurts pretty bad.
So I kindly ask you, friends, to please recycle and put your trash where? In bins and cans. Good job, friends. And we have reached the end. We are back. Wasn't that fun? Well, my dear friends, as I promised, here are some fun facts about whales. Uno. Did you know that whale poop is a great ocean fertilizer? The whale poop is rich in iron, which is a very important nutrient for all ocean creatures. For instance, the super tiny marine plants called phytoplankton eat that iron. Mmm, yummy. And then these tiny small crustaceans called krill eat those plants. And guess who eats the krill later? Fish and whales! There you go, the cycle of life.
Dos.
Did you know that whale poop was used in the makeup and perfume industry for many years? Yeah, there is an ingredient that is very valuable for these two industries and is found in the feces of the cachalot whale, which is the largest toothed whale and the largest tooth predator. And now that we're talking about teeth, here's the last fun fact. Tres. Not all whales have teeth. Did you know that whales are divided in two big groups? Those with teeth and those with baleen. Baleen is a filter feeding system inside the mouths of baleen whales. When a baleen whale is ready to eat, she opens its mouth underwater to take in water. What happens is that as she pushes the water out, tiny creatures such as krill are filtered by the baleen and become the whale's food. Baleen whales mostly eat small creatures and marine plants, whereas toothed whales are known as the predators of the ocean because their diet consists of fish. And the bigger, the better. That is all for today. See you in the next video or story. Adios, adios.